Friends, today we are going to see the emotional EMF again, but in a totally different perspective. So the topic of discussion is the same, called emotional EMF. If I assume that you have seen my previous lecture, which says electromagnetic induction emotional EMF, and this is emotional EMF part 2, so I assume that you have seen that video. And if you remember that in that video we have derived the formula for EMF, in emotional EMF, that formula is your VVL. Okay? And what happened in that video? In that video we saw that if there is a resistance, if there is a track like this, and you have a rod which is moving with velocity V placed in a magnetic field, then the rod experiences a due to change in flux, the rod develops or the system develops a emotional EMF, and that EMF causes a current to flow in the circuit, and we saw the force also, ILP, and many things. Now the question here in today's discussion is, are we able to derive this with some alternate method? Answer is yes, we are going to derive this, plus it opens up some more ideas also. So we are going to derive this today with the help of Lorentz force. Okay. Let's try to understand over here. So the whole idea is going to change for a moment now. Remember the previous derivation was based on flux. We found the change in area, then we take a change in area by time taken, and then from there we got the value of EMF. Okay. Now in today's class what we are going to see now is this. Consider that rod only. Just take that rod only. And that rod is moving with velocity V. That obviously means that if this rod is moving with velocity V, then what about the charged particles over here? Let us talk about electron, okay? And it is placed in a magnetic field over here. This is a magnetic field V. So let us consider that electron over here for a moment. Lorentz force says that the formula of Lorentz force is QV cross B. This is equal to, now the charge, if I am considering electron, electron has a negative charge, so minus E. Velocity is in this direction, so I will write velocity as I cap. Field is in inside direction, so I will write field as minus K cap. And that is equal to minus E V times of B, I cross K. I cross K is J. Sorry, I cross K is minus J, but I cross minus K is J. Okay? If you remember this logic here as I cap, J cap and K cap, I cross K is minus, because this is positive cycle. This one is positive cycle. If you go opposite to that, you get negative values. I cross K is minus J. But there is a minus K cap. So that means the J will be positive. So this is J cap. Now you take this minus sign inside over here. So what will you get? You will get EVD minus J. This is the force. Or if you want to use the right hand thumb rule, this is your V cross B upward, but since electron is negative charge, flip it downward. Remember I told you this, that for negative you have to flip it down. So ultimately you will get a direction as minus J. That means what is happening? As the rod moves, it is pushing all the electrons inside the metal. It is pushing all the electrons in the downward direction because it is going to experience a force due to which the electron starts getting accumulated at the lower end. Correct? If the electron has got detached, obviously it has got detached from a free a neutral atom only. When you take a neutral atom and if you take out the electron, goes to the one end, then the remaining ions, the positive ions, will shift upward, V cross B positively go up, so at the top the positive starts getting accumulated. Okay? Or you can see from here also, just imagine if I stop my steps over here and just think that E is no longer minus E, that E is Q, only Q. Then you will get Q V cross B plus. Okay? If it is minus, then we write minus and then we take the minus here and then it goes here. So what you have to write here is this. As per the Lorentz force, the negative charge experiences force एक्सपीरियंस फोर्स डाउनवर्ड एंड पॉजिटिव चार्ज एक्सपीरियंस फोर्स. इन एग्जाम यू आर नॉट सपोज टू राइट दिस सिंबल्स ऑफ नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव. इफ इट्स बोर्ड एग्जाम दिस नीड टू बी रिटन एज फुल पॉजिटिव एंड दिस टू बी रिटन एज नेगेटिव एंड दिस इज एज पॉजिटिव इन फुल लेटर्स. सो पॉजिटिव चार्ज एक्सपीरियंस फोर्स अपवर्ड. ओके एंड हियर यू राइट ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन and then you write like this, so it is downward. Obviously the opposite will be in the upward direction. Okay, so and then here in the diagram you write this one as force upward and this force is downward. Okay, write this as minus E. Fine, so this will go up, this will go down. Now as the charge separation takes place because of Lorentz force, let us say after some time, at one instant, let us say, at one instant, and that instant is very fast when I am talking with respect to electrons and all, that happens immediately also. At one instant, what happens? Watch this very carefully now. So, these electrons are what? Just write here as minus E. So, I will write this, represent this as minus. Okay? You better you write this also as minus only here. This changes, the right is minus 1, negative charge. So if I consider this to be minus over here and this as plus over here, let us consider that this builds up an electric field, because charge separation happens. If there is a charge separation, there will be an electric field starting from plus to minus. So there will be an electric field. Now, if I consider an electron, this electron was experiencing a Lorentz force in the downward direction, and that force was, let us call this as F due to magnetic field B. At one instant, the separation will take place, it's a continuous happening, So as the charge separation is taking place, there's an electric field also is getting built up slowly. So as the charge separation takes place, there is an electric field gradually increasing, and at one instant, the electric field has attained that value in which this force experienced by the electron equalizes with the force of magnetic field. Okay, so in that case, now the electron has attained equilibrium. Now the net force on the electron has become zero. Before this event, the electric field was less because the charges are still going slowly above. Okay, that means the magnetic field force was still dominating, but you are sending more and more, so that will gradually build up more and more electric field, and at one instant EE and FB will become same. Now you may be wondering that why this force is acting upward. Now remember, this is very interesting, very old and interesting concept, that a negative charge experiences a force in the direction opposite to electric field, and I have emphasized quite a lot of time in my lectures that a negative charge experiences force in a direction opposite to electric field, because they always tend to go towards the positive side due to electrostatic nature. So, when EE becomes equals to FB, at one instant, when EE becomes equals to FB, I can now write as FB as, what is FB? The magnitude part over here, EBB. So, this is your EBB. EE gets cancelled out. So you will get the value of E as V times of B. Now how will you write E? E is electric field. Make sure you are writing that E is electric field, not EMF right now. For EMF, I use a different symbol of E. So E equal to VB. Now this E I can write as potential difference divided by length. What is the length of this rod? Length is L. And what is delta V? Delta V is the potential difference across the two end of the rod. So delta V by L is equal to V times of. This is capital V. From where I am getting? I am getting this result from, remember this formula of minus dV by dr, and this can be written for a constant field as delta V by delta R. Okay? So I am using that logic over here. So E is equal to potential difference divided by L. Some books only write V, just write V, not delta V. It's your wish. If you want to write V, you write V. If you want to write delta V, you write delta V. But V stands for potential difference between the two ends.
Okay, now it is this delta V which has caused the potential difference. It is this delta V which is causing the EMF, the electromotive force. Okay, that is equal to VV times of L. That is, delta V is equal to EMF, the electromotive force.
Don't write here in keystone. Delta V by L is equal to VV. This implies delta V is equal to VVL, potential difference and velocity. Okay, delta V is potential difference across the end of the rod. So far so good. I am going to draw this part. Which is the EMF, which is the EMF of the rod, and which is equal to VVL, and hence we have L. Okay. So this is EMF symbol. This is electric field symbol. Now, what is, how do I know that this is the EMF of the cell? When I am writing that, which is the EMF of the rod? Okay. How? Now, remember the battery. What does the battery does? Remember a battery? A battery has a plus concentration and a minus concentration. We call it as high potential and we call it as low potential. What has happened over here? What has happened over here is the same thing. What has happened over here is the same thing. You have created a plus concentration and minus concentration. High potential and low potential, same thing. That's the reason why I am specifying that PT across the end of the rod and which is the EMF of the rod, VVL. Okay. I have seen questions in the entrance examination as well as board examination which says that if the rod is moving like this, which end will create higher potential? Okay. So you have to just tell that if the rod is moving like this and the velocity and the magnetic field is inside, just you use your V cross B method. Take this as V cross B. V cross B. Remember, this is the direction of positive. For negative, you have to flip. So V cross B, positive has shifted upward, negative has shifted downward. That means this end will be at high potential, this end will be at low potential. And we are going to discuss some numericals based on that. Okay. So always remember one thing. What is the advantage of this type of concept? So, if they ask you in board exam that derive this using Lorentz force, and we have derived this in the Lorentz force, so E is equal to BVL, same result of motional EMF we are getting, okay? But here we don't write that this will cause a current. Remember, there is no option of current because I am only making a rod to move your magnetic field. And this rod is cutting through the magnetic field, which is creating all this EMF thing. But as such, if I say current, no, there is no current right now because I have not let any complete circuit to current to flow. Okay, so right now it has only EMF. If you want current to be developed, that we are going to see now. Okay, so we are going to see that part now. Same thing what we discussed in the last class, same thing but a different approach. So motional EMF using Lorentz force, this heading, just change the heading, the motional EMF using, this was whatever I have taught so far was motional EMF using Lorentz force. Okay. Okay, fine. Now what I am going to discuss is some numericals over here. Same thing, but see the way I will do this question though. And then I will start modifying the question. I still assume that you have seen the previous video. This is velocity V moving in that direction. Okay, motional EMF is there. We know that the motional EMF is VV here. Remember, in the last class, we used some tricks to do this to find the direction of induced EMF and all. That is absolutely correct. But in motional EMF, we can use one more shortcut. Okay, but don't for writing the direction of current.
you can use this trick very effectively. And the trick is this. If this is my velocity v and the field is inside, v cross v, where is the positive? Positive has gone up. So you just locate here as positive has gone up, negative has gone down. That means now what I can do is I can redraw the circuit, and instead of rod I can just draw a battery with plus at the top, minus at the bottom, and I can complete the circuit like this, correct? And now I know from plus the current starts. So see, automatically you are getting anticlockwise as discussed in the last class. And what is the EMF of this? EMF of this is BVL. And what is the current I? I will be is equal to EMF divided by R, and so it becomes your BVL divided by R. So the whole concept of magnetism has now reduced to an electrical circuit now, a battery and a resistance, which you are very pro in solving. Clear? So it helps this way, this logic helps us to identify the value of EMF, to identify the value of polarity, whether which one is plus or minus, and then it helps us to identify the direction of current, whether clockwise or anti-clockwise, without any headache. But if they ask you to go beyond that, that means find the current on the wire. Now we know that current is flowing like this. So this wire or this rod will have a current going in this direction, and then you can find, that is your formula of finding the force, that is equal to IL cross B. So you will get IL cross B, the force will be in the direction opposite to velocity. Okay. So now I am going to discuss few more questions which are very much interesting and easy to solve using this method. Very easy to solve using this method. Say that you have a resistance over here, one rod is moving here, one rod is moving here, there are two rods, and let us say for simple, just to have a change, I am taking a direction of current in the outward direction, okay, outward direction. This rod is having a velocity in this direction, this rod is having a velocity v in this direction, let us make it different, v1 and v2, and this is the track. The track on which we are moving, and the rod has a length of L. Both the rod has a length of L. So just first write the motional EMF. What is the motional EMF here? The motional EMF here is BV1L. And what is the motional EMF here? Motional EMF here is BV2L. Now let the direct direction of polarity. Okay. So if this is my V cross B, positive will shift down and negative will shift up. Okay. So positive will shift down. So So I will make a circuit over here with positive over here and negative over here. With this as EMF E1. And what is E1? E1 is BVL. What about this one? This is B cross B. V cross B. Positive will shift up. Positive will shift up. Negative will shift down. And this is EMF E2. It is equal to B V2 times of L, and this resistance is R. What will you do now? You write the Kirchhoff's law. It's the best thing you can do. You start from one point and you come back to the same point. Okay. Now if I start from here, first you have to assume some direction of current. Now the question will be fair enough if they give you the velocity relation. Let us say V1 is more than V2. They have to mention this. Okay. If your V1 is more than V2, I don't think it needed to be mentioned over here. No, it is not required to be mentioned over here in this case. In the next thing which I am going to discuss, it will need to be mentioned over there. Over here, let us start from here. So let us say the current is flowing like this. Current is I. So the I flows here. I is the current in the circuit. So start from here. You are going in the direction of current. That means you are going downstream. So you will write minus I times of R. Then you are going from negative to positive. Negative to positive means you are going upstream. So you will write here as plus E1. Then you are going from here to here. And then you are going from negative to positive, the upstream. So you will write here as plus E2. And that will be equals to 0. And this is equal to E1 plus E2 is equal to I times of R. And that is equal to B into L V1 plus V2. Because B and L are common, is equal to R
is equal to I, and then you take the R and you divide the R over here, and this is the current BL V1 plus V2 by R. Okay? And what if, okay, make a note here. Okay, you can pause the video and make a note here. And then I just make this question number one and make a note here. And now let us say that I want to change this question by a slight, a small change in it. And what I'm saying now, let us say that the velocity is V2 in this direction now. So in this case, somebody has to provide you the relationship whether V1 is more or V2 is more. Now, what is happening over here? Let's try to see that this is still not changed. So V cross B, positive will shift down, negative will shift up, positive, negative. What is happening here? V cross B, positive will shift down, negative will shift up. So positive will shift up, negative will shift down. Okay? Now if I write the Kirchhoff's law, start from here, so this is a downstream, that is minus I times of R, then this becomes your upstream, that is your E1, then this becomes your downstream, plus 2 minus, so going from plus to minus, downstream, so this becomes minus, and this becomes minus, and this becomes minus, the rest everything remains same. Okay, just think over here now, think like this. Why it was earlier more EMF and now it is less EMF? Earlier the EMF was more because the velocities were in the opposite direction, trying to increase the area at a double rate. Okay, because V1 is also trying to increase the area and V2 is also trying to increase the area. Both were moving in this direction, so this rate of change of area was happening at a very faster rate. So more flux was changing, so more EMF was induced. Over here, this is the area. Correct? Now this is moving in this direction. So if V1 is more than V2, then the change in area is less. Just think of this way. V1 and V2 are same. Just think in this way. V1 and V2 are same. So if V1 and V2 are same, then the area remains same. Area remains same. The area is either increasing or decreasing. So if V1 and V2 are same, that means your flux is not changing. So EMF will be also equal to zero. So this is the way you need to do this type of question. That if E1 is dominating here, if E1 velocity is more than E2, then let us consider this part also. Why to keep this part aside? Just now bring back the same thing without the batteries over here. Now since this was dominating, so the current is basically flowing like this. This was having a velocity of V2 in this direction, this was having a velocity of V1 in this direction. Now let's try to see the direction of current. So direction of force. And the field was outside. This is what I was contributing here, correct? Now remember the force formula. The force formula is IL times of B, IL cross B. Now current is downward direction. So IL, okay, I have to go that side. Field is outside. So IL cross B. Where is the force? On this rod, force is acting in this direction. This is the force. What about this rod? On this rod, IL cross B, force is acting in this direction. So this force will try to increase this velocity and this force will try to decrease its velocity. Beautiful. So everything comes out directly. The one which was dominating, the force is trying to reduce it. The one which was lagging behind, minus V2, okay, who is already contributing less in change in flux, the force is trying to help him. Oh, increase the flux, okay, change the flux. So this beautiful thing. Okay, so just this is also very interesting thing. Okay, now I will discuss some one marks question. It is also very important, but in interest if it comes, it's a matter of 4 marks question. We know that our Earth's horizontal magnetic field runs from south to north. Our Earth's magnetic field runs from south to north. Okay. We have also seen the value of EMF, it is equal to BBL, and I told you about this in my previous lecture, very quickly I told you about this, that if this is my length L and if this is my velocity V, then we look for perpendicular component, and the perpendicular component for this L, which makes an angle of theta, is L, this one, which is perpendicular to velocity, is your L sine theta. Remember, this was your L and this angle is theta, so thus this angle will be also theta. Okay, so you have to create the perpendicular components. Okay, so the L sine theta must be perpendicular to V, or V sine theta must be perpendicular to R, but they need to be perpendicular. That means if they are perfectly parallel, that means if the rod is moving in this direction, it is like this. The length of the rod is parallel to V. In this case, you cannot induce any EMF over here. Now we can come back to this my concept over here. The earth has a magnetic field in this direction now, running from south to north. I am a person towards this side, so I am facing towards Gujarat. I am running from Assam and I am facing towards Gujarat. On that side I have Kashmir and on this side I have Kanyakumari, correct? So the field is from Kanyakumari to Kashmir. It is in this direction, south to north. And now I am the rod. Let us say my human body is conducting body. So when I start running, this is my rod. When I start running, my velocity is in this direction, correct? And my length is perpendicular. So I just use this one, okay? This pen is my velocity. So I am the rod, and this is the velocity direction. So I am moving like this, and the field, the marker is the field in this direction, okay? So field velocity. So if I have to do the Lorentz part, V cross B, that means inside my body, all the positive will shift down. And V cross B, if I shift it up, all the negative charge will shift in the upward direction, correct? So the head will be at lower potential and my feet will be at higher potential if I am running like this, okay? Interesting thing. Now, I am from Gujarat and now I am running towards Assam, correct? And the field is still from Kanyakumari to Kashmir, running in this direction. And this is the velocity direction. So V cross B, all positive will shift up and the negative will shift down. Now my head is at positive potential, high potential, and leg is at negative potential, low potential. Correct? This is a very interesting thing. Now there are questions which they ask based on your aircraft. Aircraft has wings, correct? We have seen the wings, big wings. Okay, so for aircraft, just keep this from Kanyakumari to Kashmir in this direction. Okay, just keep that from Kanyakumari to Kashmir in this direction. So it is in this direction. Now, if the aircraft, these are the two ends of the wings. Okay, these are the two ends of the wings. Now, let us say that the aircraft is making a landing like this. It is making a landing like this. Okay. That means if it is, this is the aircraft thing, okay? So that means it will have a velocity in this direction. Wow. Okay. So this black end is the, whatever you see in the camera over here is your velocity direction. So if the aircraft is making a land like this, look at here. The velocity and field are parallel to each other, yeah? If the velocity and field are parallel to each other, you cannot do a cross product. You cannot do a cross product because velocity and field should also be perpendicular to each other. Velocity and field should be also perpendicular to each other. That is the prime criteria of Lorentz force, V cross B. Okay? In this case, nothing will happen. Nothing. Now just imagine now it is making a land like this. It's making a landing like this. Okay, so it's flying from Gujarat, these are the two wings, and then it is landing in the Guwahati airport like this. So if I do this V cross B plus minus, so the thickness of the wing, the top part may have V cross B, the positive, the lower part will have minus. Not interesting. I want something to get developed across the wings. That can be very interesting now. How that can be possible? Now that can be possible if the aircraft is making a
you know, the aircraft has gone up and now it is coming down like this. Oh, for some moment, he's not going to land, don't worry. He's just going like this, down. So, he is flying in air, like this, and now suddenly he wants to go down like this. This magnetic field, Earth's magnetic field. Okay. V, this is your V cross B. V cross B. B is inside. V cross B. Positive shifts over here. Negative shifts over here. Plus, minus. Plus, minus. Same thing when it's trying to take off like this. Minus, plus, ulta ho jao. So when they are cutting the field from top to bottom or from bottom to top, then across the wings the potential gets developed. Okay? So these are the questions which they ask. Thank you for watching the video. We will meet again in the next class with some new topics and new concepts. Thank you for watching.